Hello children, in today's class we will learn about India's landforms. You know, India is a big and beautiful country. It has a variety of landforms: mountains, valleys, plains, plateaus and deserts. You know, landform is a natural feature on the earth's surface. Children, peninsula is a piece of land almost surrounded by water. You can see in this picture that peninsular India is bordered by the Arabian Sea, the Indian Ocean and the Bay of Bengal. India has oceans and seas to the east, west and south, as it is clearly visible in this picture. And now look at this picture. In the west, it has Arabian Sea. In the east, it has Bay of Bengal. And in the south, it has Indian Ocean. Its islands lie in the seas on the east and west. In the east, it has Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and in the west, India has Lakshadweep Islands. So these are the two island groups of India, the Lakshadweep Islands and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Children, based on its landforms, India's land may be divided into six broad regions, that is, the Northern Mountains, the Northern Plains, the Thar Desert, the Peninsular Plateau, the Coastal Plains, and the Islands. As you can see in this picture, it is showing the different landforms in India. Today we are going to learn about the Northern Mountains. A number of high mountain ranges form the northern boundary of India. The northernmost of these is Karakoram Range. To its south is the Himalaya. This is the Karakoram Range. Children, the Himalaya is made up of three main ranges. From north to south, they are the Great Himalaya. Then the Lesser Himalaya and the Outer Himalayas. You can see in this map, number one, Greater Himalaya. Number two, here, Lesser Himalaya. And number three is Outer Himalaya, which is also called Shivaliks. The Great Himalaya has some of the world's highest peaks. Among these are Mount Everest. This is the location of the Mount Everest on map, and this is the real picture of Mount Everest. And you know, children, the Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. And the Kanchenjunga is the third highest peak in the world. It is the location of the Kanchenjunga, and this is the real picture of Kanchenjunga. Kanchenjunga is in India, but the Mount Everest location is in Nepal. Children, the peaks of the high mountains are covered with snow like this. Many of them have glaciers moving down their slopes. You know, a glacier is a very large mass of ice that moves slowly down a slope. As glaciers move to the lower parts, warmer parts of a mountain, they melt. As you can see in this picture, the resulting water often forms rivers. So, the Ganga rises from a glacier called Gangotri. You can see in this picture, it is the Gangotri Glacier. And the Yamuna rises from a glacier called Yamunotri. Children, this is the location of Gangotri and Yamunotri on map. There are many beautiful valleys in the Himalaya. The Kashmir Valley is one of them. First of all, you need to understand what is a valley. So, it is a long, low area between hills or mountains. Now, look at Kashmir Valley. Another is Dehradun Valley. Dun means valley. You know, the mountains have many hill stations too, like Shimla, Nainital, Mussoorie and Darjeeling. We often go to these hill stations in our summer vacation, isn't it? Now, let's talk about the life in the mountain. It's very difficult to build roads, railways and towns in the mountains. So few people live here. The cold climate is good for growing fruits such as apples, pears and walnuts. Tea is grown in the eastern Himalaya. This is a tea garden. Children, herding animals, tourism and making handicrafts such as carpets and woolen things are other ways of earning a living. So I hope today's topic is clear to you. Thank you.